Hi everyone, I'm Shuge Wang, a PhD student at Queen Mary, and in this video I will discuss my PhD project, which looks at spontaneous civilization in domestic chicks. Humans and some precocial animals, such as the domestic chick, have the capacity to quickly generalize with limited experience. For example, young chicks are able to recognize and follow their mother soon after hatching. The fact that even inexperienced chicks can quickly generalize suggests that experience is not required for effective generalization. It remains unclear what strategies are used in fast generalization. From previous literature, we know that both infants and chicks have predispositions for certain features, which means that they show spontaneous preferences that are not acquired through experience. The aim of this study is to clarify the role of predispositions in fast generalization. The domestic chick is a perfect animal model for this, as extensive literature has shown that they are strongly predisposed towards some features. And one consistent finding is that they prefer red and blue, or yellow and green. And we also know that chicks can generalize through phyllo imprinting, which is a fast learning mechanism in which the chick develops a strong preference towards an individual or object. We first imprinted the chicks on either a red, yellow, blue, or green moving circle, with red and blue being the predisposed colors, and yellow and green being non-predisposed. They were then presented with the imprinting stimulus and one of eight test stimuli presented sequentially. Each adjacent color pair are approximately equally spaced from each other. We measured the chick's preference for the familiar color using the proportion of time they spent near the imprinting stimulus. And in a follow-up experiment, we imprinted the chicks on an intermediate color, either orange or turquoise, and we tested the preference for that color when there's a novel color present that could either be more or less predisposed. We imprinted and tested the chicks in individual automated controlled rearing arenas like these ones, with two monitors on opposite sides that presented the stimuli in a preset pseudo-randomized order. We tracked the chicks' movement and the position of the stimuli using a deep learning toolbox called Deep Block Cut. Moving on to the results, we found that chicks imprinted on red and blue showed greater preferences for the familiar color when the test color was more distant from the imprinting color, and lower preferences for the familiar color when the test color was closer to the imprinting color. This suggested that chicks have the capacity to generalize colors in phyllo imprinting. However, we found that adult chicks were able to quickly generalize when imprinted on the predisposed red and blue. Those that were imprinted on the non-predisposed yellow and green showed no generalization. This is despite the fact that they spent a similar amount of time near the imprinting stimulus during the imprinting phase on day one. And this suggests that even when the chicks were equally attentive to the four imprinting colors, they still showed a lack of generalization for colors that were non-predisposed. This was further supported by our results from experiment 2, which showed that chicks imprinted on intermediate color, turquoise, showed greater preference for the imprinting stimulus when the test stimulus was less predisposed, and lower preference for the imprinting stimulus when the test stimulus was more predisposed, even though they had the same color distances. To conclude, the aim of this study was to clarify the role of predispositions in fast generalization. As we predicted, chicks were able to generalize to novel colors in phyllo imprinting. However, this was only the case for chicks imprinted on the predisposed stimuli, red and blue, and not for those imprinted on non-predisposed stimuli, yellow and green. When chicks were imprinted on an intermediate color, they showed greater preferences for the color that is more predisposed, disregarding the color distance. This suggests that mere exposure was not sufficient for spontaneous generalization, and that predisposition play an integral role in facilitating generalization. We suggest that it's possible that predispositions attract and orient the chick towards the predisposed stimuli, thereby supporting the chick's capacity to quickly generalize. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me at my email address.